Alright, that's fine with me. I wonder if actually boarding into black would be something worth considering. I wouldn't get very many creatures, but I would get Agent of Fates as one of them, so maybe we'll consider for game three. Just the double swamp draw from him. I'm not going to play around anything. Yeah, that's the one card that I would be playing around. But yeah, we're just going to let it happen. If I had a God's Willing in hand, then I probably would play around that. But there's no point in playing Scholar, since he's just going to have the cure anyway later on. Wow. Though it would have definitely changed the tempo of this game. I wish I could cast a Pharah here. But if I can cast it soon, I think it'll still be worth it. And by worth it, I mean good enough to possibly put us over the top to win this game. If I miss next turn, then it's starting to get pretty bad. Alright, you can choose between Plains and Nyxborn Shieldmate. I'm guessing you're going to take the Nyxborn Shieldmate. Alright, Island, please. That's not even remotely good. Debating on whether I should actually cast Scholar or just save it for the Pharah. Waiting could cost us. Well, could take too long. And he sure did play that one quickly, too. Alright. See if we can get there off this. Oh, it's gonna take a while to find out. It'd be really nice if I had a Hopeful Eidolon. I think I saw one. I'm not sure, though. Yep, figured. That is just absurd. That just gets me. Just double Great Merchant twice. I mean, I'm not dead yet this game, obviously, but I just have this sneaking suspicion that his next turn's play is going to be also pretty brutal. Awkwardly, I feel like I have to cast that to try to get this going. And that would be the point of saving the Scholar, was that I'd cast it this turn. But, like I said, I didn't want to risk taking too much damage. So we got a creature off it, that's good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Getting really close to Devotion, too. Scorpion, okay, that's fine. I'm perfectly okay with that. Yep. That is so absurd. 2, 4, 6, 8. I'm going to 2. I'm not dead. Oh, I'm not going to 2. I gotta tap a guy. I boarded this guy in for a reason. And this is it. Okay, now this is Breaching Hippocamp's Time to Shine. Nope. Okay, that would have been nice. So without Hippocamp, I think we can block just barely okay. We're gonna lose at least one guy, probably two guys, as far as getting this guy active goes. Okay, that there. That there. That there. I lose one guy. Take one. And then I think that's the best thing I can do. I could risk going to one, but I'm not doing that. I'm just going to take the one and try to live another turn. Sweet. So we get to start activating Scholar. Triggering this, if relevant. Probably not relevant. But I definitely take the drum over a land there. It is worse than any actual card, though, I think. Because getting this active would change this game dramatically. But getting the Scholar active is very good. And now that we've drawn Disciple, Pharaoh will probably be active if we live this turn. Okay, this Hypnotist can go ahead and die. It's not really necessary to do it right now, but I'm going to go ahead and do it. Technically, that was extremely incorrect, because there's a card, Asphyxiate, I think is the card. Destroy target untapped creature, and I just walked right into that. So, that was stupid, but I'll try to remember that in the future. Alright, we're at 4 life, technically 5. Can we attack? I believe we can, but I'm not going to. We could probably attack with the Affair, if anything, because if he kills any creature, then it's not active anymore. So that is the one thing we could do. But then our blocking is actually fine. I'm just not going to do it. Just there could be something that gets me for that, and I feel like this game is still going to go pretty long. And he does in fact have Shredding Winds. That's too bad. That sucks. I draw a card, but it sucks. Okay, that's fine. Not a problem. Oops. We already used our God's Willing. No, we didn't. Okay, let's. So the fact that I even did that on accident probably gives away that I don't have it, but I could still draw it. Okay, now we have an option. So if I play both, I lose a card in the long run, but this does become active, and I don't risk anything happening to my cards. Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and play both. He has another Disciple in his deck, so. And this time, I should probably attack. No, I shouldn't have attacked. Ugh. Yeah, because this time he has this guy. Reaching hippocamp? Nope. Black Oak, what does this card do? Defender. Okay, that's all I really need to know. So you can tap three creatures at the moment. Tap up to five, make it a 5/10. That is pretty difficult to get past. That's another untapped creature, so 4/9. Well, let's see. He only has to tap a few to get big enough to stop the Aphera. Finally, God's willing. Go ahead and play that and attack. Now, yeah, he can block the Aphera with this. So I could Vortex. I think we're just gonna play defensively, do nothing. It's too difficult to get past the tree folk. Yeah, he's gonna start growing his guy, that's fine. Yeah, well, that makes it easier. And I don't need to tap anything, which is that might make it easier for me to get past the oak. Okay, if I slam Emissary onto, I guess I have to do it to a Pharaoh, because it's the only thing I can really attack with. I think I'm in okay shape for that to work out. Yeah, I'm in fine shape. Oh, there's something I didn't consider though. And I just now realized I should be playing around Raise Dead effect. 2, 4, 6, 7. Well, I can barely survive at this point, so that's good. I'll be at 1 if it does happen. Or no. He has Moses Marauder in his graveyard. I've always been dead to a Raise Dead effect. For a few turns, I think. Quite a few turns. So, I guess this might have been correct then. Because if I am in fact dead to that, I need to kill him before he draws one. I can block. I can tap one creature and block none. So I would be very, very dead. Okay. I'm in the same exact position. This time he has to block the Aphera though. So I'm slowly getting closer to not being dead to a Raise Dead. I don't think there's any way I could speed that up. Making use of God's Willing is a potential way I could do that, but I don't think I can do that yet. Like, if I could tap this guy, give protection from black, he has to block with a 5/5, and I'm at virtual 9. And let's assume he'll, I can't think of all the Raise Dead effects. There's There's one that gets back two creatures, in which case I don't think there's anything I can do. I would just die. Obviously, if you block to the Grey Merchant, I'm dead to that card, to returning two creatures. Yeah, there's nothing I can really do. I just have to attack, and whatever I tap is mostly irrelevant. I don't know. Tap that. I guess him blocking with the green creature is better. Because then I can God's Willing. Oh no, I could have just killed him. I could have just killed him. No, I couldn't have. Yeah, I could have. I could have killed him. He just blocked with the green creature too. For whatever that's worth. So I could have just killed him. Would I have done it? Would I have God for it? I'm pretty sure I would have. So I could have Protection from Black, Ephera tap this guy, and then Emissary tap this guy. He goes to one, and I kill him a Scholar. So I give him an extra turn to draw a raised dead effect. And I think that's the only thing he could draw. Can't believe I didn't see that after all that consideration too. What's more interesting though is that he's not blocking with the merchant, even though I'm giving him the choice to. If he did have a raised dead effect, I feel like he would do that. It depends on the raised dead effect, I suppose. If he had the March of the Returned, pretty sure he would block with it. If he had Farika's I don't know what that card's called. Before I do this, I need to make sure I'm not in too precarious a position. Because I could just God's Willing. No, he only has four attackers, I'm fine. I'm just guessing he didn't see it. He just wanted to kill my guy. And I definitely don't want to use the God's Willing if I don't have to. And you know what? I could also use this potentially to save myself from a Mogus's Marauder if I were to target this. It's not worth thinking about right now because I'm about to kill him. Protection from Black. I'll attack first. Could have done it during my upkeep, in fact. Scry. That would have actually been worth it. Interesting. He just concedes right there. I feel like that was unnecessary. Maybe he just didn't have any raised deads. Doesn't really make sense. He's playing the Commune deck. Well, maybe he's just playing Commune because he has double Grey Merchant. So I got out of that one. Now let's see if we want to play Black-White. So we have... it's not too bad so far. Five black cards. I might still splash blue. Hey, I could actually get behind this. I would play that one. And then Grizzly Transformation or Traveling Philosopher. So I would have access to three black creatures for blocking those Intimidate cards. The only real upside is Agent of Fates, which I have tons of ways to target. I don't think it's consistent enough. And like those very few black creatures that I am bringing in, I don't think is worth it. Rather, I don't think it's enough to make it worth it.